Hi everybody, my name is Antoinette and welcome to Board Game Inquisition, where we're here to offer you insight and information about your board games. So, how do you feel about horses? Have you ever dreamt of owning your own ranch, entering your horses in events, and emerging victorious? Well, if so, then here's five things I think you'll need to know about Fantasy Ranch. Fantasy Ranch from Fantasy Board Games LLC is a horse-themed board game for 2-4 players. In it, you're the owner of your own ranch, which you grow and improve by competing in equine events. The winner is the person with the best ranch at the end of the game. Mechanics-wise, this is a hand management game with some dice rolling and area control thrown in for good measure. You start the game with your own ranch, some horses and some resources, and on your turn you can perform one action. So you can buy a horse from the face-up tableau, and these will cost you carrots. You can buy a building from your own player board of the ranch, which costs you cowboy boots, or you can have your ranch create goods for you for the turn, and then you can use those on actions 1 and 2. Now, at the end of each round, you have to attend an event with your horse, and you want to have the right type of horse for the right event to help you emerge victorious. The game ends once all the events are over, and the winner's scores are totted up by how well you've kind of enhanced your ranch and by how many horses you have in your stables. Now, I'd like to point out that there are 3 different difficulty modes with which to play this, which would unlock further abilities and things that you can do. And there's also a mode designed specifically for children. Similar games to Fantasy Ranch. While the mechanics in it do feel familiar, I don't think I've played anything quite like it. I will say, however, that it's clear that this game is aimed at families. Setup is quick and straightforward, just laying out some cards into a tableau, and the rulebook is easy and definitely family friendly. It takes about 30 to 40 minutes for 2 of us to play, and the turns are lightning fast. Replayability wise, there's lots here, as there's huge variation in the horses you can acquire, the ranches you can own, and also the fact that you can add or subtract different elements based on the difficulty level you want to play. Aesthetically, Fantasy Ranch is a veritable treasure trove. I absolutely love the fact that they have real horses on the horse cards with their own names. Also, your ranch you have is a real world ranch. It's one you could actually go and visit. Also, the drawings on all of the boards are really, really cute and quaint, and they remind me of something like Where's Wally or Where's Waldo if you're American. And to top all of that off, you get some adorable teeny tiny horse meeples. This box is brimming with fantastic components, and it brought a huge smile to my face. And you can hear how much so in my unboxing video if you want to check that out. So, what's so special about Fantasy Ranch? I think it has to be the way it incorporates real-world equine sensibilities into a board game. This really feels realistic, so much so that they actually have real companies advertising in the game as sponsorship for the events your horses attend. And instead of it coming across as kind of cheesy and cheap, it really feels authentic and genuine. And to be fair, everything about this game does. How do I really feel about Fantasy Ranch? Firstly, the negatives. So winning the horse shows comes down to a dice roll, and for me that takes the game from being great to being good. For sure there's plenty here that's appealing, but the meat of the game is kind of lacking, at least for a seasoned gamer. The positives. This game without doubt is a family game, but a way that handles that weight is pretty clever. So by being able to adjust the difficulty modes, you can play it with both younger people and with more seasoned gamers. And don't worry about that kind of family-friendly attitude, there's still plenty here to keep adults entertained. As a horse lover, this game just oozed joy for me. But I'd like to point out that I don't think you need to really love horses to enjoy this. A lot of the people I played it with had no interest in horses at all, but were really enamored by kind of the pictures and the names of the horses. And we had a lot of fun announcing which one of our horses we were sending to what event. To be fair, everybody really kind of enjoyed themselves. And finally, I don't think this game is aimed at me, but I think I really enjoyed it. And while sure I don't have a family of my own, I can definitely see this as the kind of game that people will love and share and treasure. So, do I think you should have Fantasy Ranch in your collection? Well, if you've got someone in your life who's really big into horses, I don't think you could find a better representation of it in the board game world. It's really fantastic. But beyond that, if you wanted something you could play with your children perhaps, or with your family, something that obviously has adjustable modes, so you know, you can control the difficulty, but also something that looks really, really stunning and is super engaging, then I think you'd be crazy not to check out Fantasy Ranch. You've been watching Board Game Inquisition. If you've got any comments or queries you'd like to make about Fantasy Ranch, why not leave them in the comment box below? Or if you'd like to do something nice, why not like or subscribe to the channel or tell a friend I exist? And until next time, I'll be here playing games, asking questions, and of course, perusing my collection. Take care.